love her more than anyone else. And bring her in your presence today. Make her what you want her to be. I pray to hear her heart. I pray.
The treasure, the treasure. myself to you. God has enabled me to walk with you faithfully. Trials lie ahead. I will love you and pray with you, and through it all, I will stay with you. Our home will be a refuge of unconditional love.
Thank you. precious name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We all are here for the holy matrimonial of the Shane Lutro and Miss Vivian Christensen. This afternoon, I would like to welcome each one to this auspicious occasion of marriage. On behalf of both families and CSM and our congregation, I welcome Reverend Thomas Chalian, Reverend Jody Joy Mullikal, Reverend J. Williams, the choir members, CSA Melana Congregation of Senior Court, all of these members, both family members and friends for this very discernment. This service will take 1 hour. I request each of you to participate in this wedding ceremony with a prayer and faith. Let us all together sing, "To God be the glory."
Holy are you, all my Jesus.
We are gathered here in the presence of God, and this congregation is joined together as a team in Rebbe in Mary. This is a way of life instituted by God, and the Holy Scripture commands all people to follow it in order. Our Lord Jesus Christ, blessed be His presence at hand and gathering. About this way of life, hear what our Lord Jesus said. From the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one. So they are no longer two, but one. What therefore God has joined together, let not man put asunder. Marriage is therefore not by any to be undertaken lightly or inadvisedly, but seriously and prayerfully, duly considering the purpose for which it is ordained. That husband and wife give to each other lifelong great companionship, help and comfort, both in prosperity and in adversity. That God may hallow and direct the natural instincts and affections created by himself and believe. That children may be born and brought up in families in the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ to the glory of God. That marriage being thus held in honor, human society may stand upon firm foundation. These two persons, faith and revere, have come here to be made one in his holy history. But if anyone here knows any just cause, why they may not be married according to the discipline of the church, and the law of this land, let him or her now make it known, or else for our all together. I charge you both, in the presence of God, that if either of you know any reason why you may not be joined together in marriage, you do not. Let us pray. Almighty and most perfect Father, without whose help we cannot do anything as we ought, we pray that as you have brought King and Rebbe together by thy covenant, so you will enrich them with your grace, that they may enter into marriage covenant as in your sight, and truly keep the law they are about to be through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Congregation, may seat. Will you take Rebbe to be your wife? Will you love her, comfort, and honor her? Give her in sickness and in health, and give to her a Lord, so long as you both will be able. Rebbe, will you take Shane to be your husband? Will you love him, comfort, and honor him? Give him in sickness and in health, and cleave to him, and also love as long as you both shall live. Who gives Rebbe to be married Shane?
I shame.
Take you, Rebbe.
Take you, Rebbe.
To be my wife. To have. And to fall from. This day forward.
This day forward.
For better. Or for worse.
For
richer. Or for poorer. In sickness. And in health. To love. Cherish. And protect. Till death do us part, according to God's holy law. I give you my pledge.
give you Shane to be my husband, to have and to call from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love, cherish and protect till death do us part, according to God's holy law. And this I give you, my friends. Hold us here, your oath, and we are in witness. Ramya, I marry you with this ring that I give to you as a token of constant faith and abiding love. I honor you with my body and all my worldly goods with you. I share in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Shane, I give you this ring as a token of constant faith and abiding love. I honor you with my body and all my worldly goods to you. I share in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us all stand and sing the congregation sing. While the choir is singing, the room will tie the whistle and we are being underway.
Thank you.
heaven and earth is named, send thy blessings upon Shane and Remya, whom we bless in thy name, as Isaac and Rebecca, who are blessed in thy name, that they be faithfully together, they may surely perform and keep the vow and covenant made between them, and may ever remain perfect law and peace together, and live according to thy law, through Jesus Christ our Lord. As Shane, son of Mr. Mariani Lucas, and Mrs. Mary Lucas, member of CSA Malayalam Congregation of Greater New York Seaford, and Remya, daughter of Mr. Thomas Christensen, and Mrs. Elizabeth Christensen, members of Church of South India, Christ Church of Connecticut, we have made their pledge to each other before God and before this congregation. I declare that they are now husband and wife, according to the law of this land and the ordinance of God, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Whom therefore God has joined together, let no one put asunder. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, bless to serve and keep you. The Lord mercifully take upon you with your word, and fill you with all spiritual bendition, please, that you may so live together in this life, and that in the world to come you may have life everlasting. Now the choir will sing Psalm 128 in Malayalam.
Thank you. choose you. You choose just what you say. Though the storms may come and the winds may blow, I remain steadfast and let my heart learn. When you speak your word, it will come to pass. Great is your faithfulness to me. Great is your faithfulness to me. From the rising sun to the setting sea, I will praise your name. Great is your faithfulness to me.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us.
Lord,
not get our strength from the face of the enemy. O Lord, hear our prayer.
And let our cry come to you.
Let us pray, eternal God, creator and preserver of all life. Give us all grace, look with favor upon the world you have made and redeemed, especially upon your servants, Shane and Remia. Give them the wisdom and devotion in their life, that each may be to the other strength in need, a counselor in their life, a comfort in sorrow, and a companion in joy. Grant that their wills may be knit together in your will and their spirit in your spirit, that they may grow in love and peace with you and each other all the days of their life. Give them grace when they hurt each other, recognize and confess their fault, and seek each other's forgiveness and yours. Make their life together a sign of Christ's love to the sinful and broken world, and grant that bearing one another's burdens, sharing one another's joy, and together fulfilling the duties of their name, they may ever be grateful to each other in love and obedience to your word, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O merciful Lord and Heavenly Father, by whose gracious gift humankind is increased, bestow, we beseech thee upon these thy servants, Shane and Remia, the heritage and gift of children. Grant that they may so live together in godly love and honor, that they may see their children brought up in Christian faith and virtue, by praise and glory, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Almighty Lord, you have taught us that it is not legitimate to separate those who are united together in the holiest state of marriage. You have sanctified marriage as a noble mystery and as a sign of spiritual union between the church and Messiah. For God, as Messiah has loved his church, the bride, and preserved and loved us, his body, may let this man and woman love each other according to thy word and grow in purity, faithfulness, peace, as long as they shall love. Lord, bless their lives so that they may be strengthened to keep the vows they have made, and all their hopes may be fulfilled in accordance with your will, experiencing the joy of our eternal kingdom. Amen. The everlasting God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named out of his glory, grant you strength and power, bless, preserve, and keep you through his Spirit in your inner being, that Christ may dwell in your hearts in love, both now and forevermore.
Now I am inviting Mr. John Thomas for Bible reading. In and you can sit now.
Chapter 13, verses 1 through 13. If I speak in the tongues of mortals and angels, but do not have love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away all my possessions, and if I hand over my body so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient, love is kind, Love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own ways. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. Love never ends. But as for prophecies, they will come to an end. As for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, it will come to an end. For we know only in part, and we prophesy only in part. But when the complete comes, the partial will come to an end. When I was a child, I spoke like a child, I thought like a child, and I reasoned like a child. But when I became an adult, I put an end to childish ways. For now, we see in a mirror, dimly, but then we will see face to face. Now I know only in part, then I will know fully, even as I have been fully known. And now, faith, hope, and love abide. These three, and the greatest of those is love.
Thank you, Jonah Thomas. In Christian marriage, sermon is very important. Reverend Jobi Choi Molekalachal is very close to Ramya's family. Achal was served as a presbyter in charge in Church of South India Christ Church in Connecticut. Presently, Achal is doing PhD in Berkeley University, California. On behalf of newlywedded couple, Mr. and Mrs. Shane Lugo, I welcome Reverend Jobi Choi Achal for the sermon.
Shane and Lumia. Now please get relax a bit. On behalf of Param Shaluti Matyatsan, Reverend Thomas Seriyachan, and our role model, dear William Achan, and on behalf of myself and all those who have gathered here, we would like to congratulate you on this auspicious occasion. May God continue to bless you abundantly in your family life. Depend upon God Almighty for all your needs, and God will surely help you to lead a meaningful and model family life. Thank you, Shailajan, for this opportunity to share the word of God during this wedding ceremony. As Achan mentioned, Remya's family is very dear to me. Remya's father and mother, they are very part of the Board of Trustees of CSI Church in Connecticut. And I understand from Shailajan that Shane's family is also very much active in C4 Church. Shane's mom is part of the Board of Trustees now. So you both have a strong Christian family tradition and atmosphere. The liturgy of the solemnization of marriage in the Church of South India is one of the unique with its strong biblical and theological foundation. The emphasis is about the lasting nature of the relationship based on the lasting love till death separate the couple. As you very well know, the Bible begins with a wedding. God himself solemnizes a wedding at the Garden of Eden, the wedding of Adam and Eve. The Bible also ends with another celestial wedding between Jesus Christ the bridegroom and George as the bride. So when we observe the worship order, the liturgy, Jesus Christ only the symbol of marriage in order to represent the relationship between Christ and Church. There are two types of husbands. types of wives. The first one is caring, loving, hardworking, kind of ideal husband or wife. The second type is your own husband or wife. So don't think that we can be an ideal person with no limitations. Perfect in all sense. So as the liturgy indicates, you have to bear one another, forgive one another, and to move forward by joining your hands. In CSI liturgy, the intention of marriage, or the whole purpose of marriage, was brought out in the worship order in the first part. It is ordained because of this. There are three reasons. One is the parity between the couple. So equality, companionship. The second one is talking about the purity of relationship. You have a nice company with your partner. And the third one is talking about posterity. So parity, purity, and posterity. You have to have generations. That is a blessing from God. Today, you both are elevated into a higher state of family life. It is surely an upward movement. So I would like to remind you three things. So I was the one officiated Remya's brother Roshan's wedding. So on that day, I was bringing Panjadatra, five tantras, five ideas. Since Remya is very active in youth movement and the church, I would only like to bring three things. Three piyutaka, like the Buddhism. Three words. So, Roshan's wedding was on Remya's birthday. Now it is a revenge. Today is Roshan's birthday. Remya is having her wedding. So I would like to remind you three words. Very simple three words. One is team up. Second one is build up. And the third one is grow up. I'll come to the first word. Team up. From now on, you are one in Christ, a team with one God. Therefore, transform the other with this relationship. You must exercise the joy of exploring each other, and knowing, understanding, and celebrating each other. Devote time and energy to communicate love. Do things together. Share dreams and aspirations with each other. Support one another. In the present world, we have plenty of contacts, but we are very poor in relationships. Shane is a doctor, and Remya is also coming from the same background. You both are so hardworking people, I know. So I don't want to explain a disease called the hikikomori. That means a severe kind of social withdrawal. You can go for that later. So doing things alone, want to travel alone, move alone, want to make no social contacts. There are people like that. Hikikomori. So don't be like that. Recently, a Bollywood actor committed suicide. His name is Sushant Singh Rajput. When we tried to know about him, he was 11.1 million Instagram followers and 1.9 million followers in Twitter. But he found himself as lonely, and he found himself as alone. Also, I said at the outset, there is no perfect husband or no perfect wife. But if you will keep believing in each other, there will be plenty of perfect moments in your family life. So try to be a team. Team up. Second one, build up. Build your family in the proper way, on a strong foundation. Being human with our family. Put all the medical professional burdens at office, hospital. When you come to the family, be human with your family. Find time to spend together, amidst of all busy schedules. It is called quality time. Learn to frame a budget. Family life is operating a bank account. If you want to withdraw, you need to deposit. Withdrawing continuously will lead us to be bankrupt. So please try to improve your relationship. Work at your marriage to build up a strong and firm family. Don't think that our world work is over, now this great the event is over, so now I can relax. No, your burden starts now. Marriage is a covenant, deals with people. People are engaged in the covenant of relationship, not things. We are very good at making contracts. Contracts are made for a limited period of time. But covenants are forever. Contracts belong to the marketplace, but your wedding is happening in a sacred place. So the covenant is made in a sacred place and celebrated till the end of life. We are many present here. I came all the way from California to attend your wedding. People will, immediately after the solemn service, people will come to you, give you shaker. They will wish you, they will celebrate with you. Above all, they all are waiting for the reception. But it is you, only you are responsible to build up your family. That you have to keep it in your mind. So from the when you made the decision to marry each other, Charlotte was helping you, I know. Then Thomas Arianacha provided you some sort of premarital counseling. And this sermon is like, I am putting some shredded coconut on the pool. So if it is a good family life, the pool has to come out from the bottom. That means the experience of team you have to experience, nobody else. So don't try to imitate any of the families who are gathered here. It is you and you only are responsible to build up your family. Finally, grow up. You both have your own prospective roles to play in the family life. You are extremely good in your profession. I know during COVID time, many of us working hard to vaccinate people in Connecticut. She vaccinated the entire congregation. So I know. So you have several other roles, but in family you have many other roles. Grow in your self-esteem, in your integrity. Grow in your faithfulness, grow in your attitudes and perspectives. Unfortunately, marriage today is not viewed as a lasting relationship, but as a contract, civil contract or arrangement. I'll tell you an example. My wife is working in the UK, so I was accompanying her to come to the US. She doesn't want to come to this land, she likes UK more. She was sharing this to a friend. A colleague. And the colleague asked, don't you like to go to the US? Do you want to be here? And she said, yeah, I like to be here more. Then the advice was, then just divorce your husband. Just divorce your husband. So there are a lot of reasons to divorce. I don't know if that is encouragement or discouragement for my wife. But there are people not saying it that way. It is a consistent covenant. Have you heard about love at first sight? Don't forget to have a second, a third, and many more looks in the days to come. There is a saying, usually you know the preachers will say, if a newly married couple laughs, people know why they laugh. If a 10-year-old couple laughs, people wonder why they laugh. So when days pass or when years pass, the bondage will lose its the energy. So there is an example in the Bible. There is a wedding event happened in Cana of Galilee, where Jesus and his disciples were present. So there, towards the end of that passage in John's Gospel chapter 2, it says, everyone serves the good wine first, and then the inferior wine after the guests have become drunk. But you have kept the good wine until now. That is the same. So Jesus performed the first miracle. It was the first sign according to John's Gospel. So while tasting the good wine, it was the command from the guest. Everyone serves the good wine first, and then the inferior wine after the guest have become drunk. But you have kept the good wine until now. John chapter 2, verse 10. Team up, build up, and grow up. May God help you to keep the good wine, that freshness of your relationship, until the end of your life. Your life is only your life. That is very much unique, and you cannot imitate anyone, even for that matter, your parents' family life. Your family life is a unique family life. Try to make a team, try to build up the family life, and try to grow up in that family life. The invisible presence of God is always there. We are performing a lot of things here. So all human. But the invisible presence of God Almighty is here. That God will surely help you to keep the good wine till the end of your life. Once again, I congratulate both of you and offer our earnest prayers for your family life. May God bless you.
Thank you, Joby Etchen, for the powerful and thought-provoking message, particularly for Shane and Ramya, those who married, those who are living the married life. I, once again, on behalf of Shane and Ramya, thank you very much, Joby Etchen. Now the board will sing the Mangala Gana in Malayalam. The time the bridegroom and bride will sign the register. But also, I invite the witness from the board side to come forward and sign the register. After that, the bride and the bridegroom will offer their offering.
Thank you. Most gracious God, we give you thanks for your tender love in sending Jesus Christ. Help Emmanuel to be born of a human mother and to make the way of the cross be the way of life. We thank you also for demonstrating the union of man and woman. By the power of your Holy Spirit, pour out abundance of your blessing. Defend us from every enemy. Lead us into all peace. Let our love for each other be a seed upon our heart, imagined above our shoulders, and a crown upon our foreheads. Bless us in our words and in our companionship, in our speaking, and in our ways, and our thoughts, and in our souls, in our life, and in our lives. By the way, in your mercy, bring us to that peace, where your saints, peace for our Lord, in your church, where Jesus Christ, our Lord,
grace to live a responsible family life. Grant that all who have with us this host today may find their lives strengthened, and that all who are valued may depart with their own promises to you. Enrich with your grace all husbands and wives, parents and children, that by loving and supporting one another, may serve those in need and be a sign of your kingdom. Grant that the bonds by which all your children and unite to one another may be so transformed by your spirit that your peace and justice may be because of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Eternal God, our Father, whose Son Jesus Christ shared the life of our earthly home and nursery, instilled in the holy estate of family, we thank you for your guidance. Lord, bless your servants who unite with us this day, and all those who have participated in this also. Grant that father and mother, husband and wife, sons and daughters, be with you, and those who in common fellowship and love for one another, and make every Christian home a place of truth, goodness, and experience in God's kingdom. In Jesus Christ, who have loved us by giving this precious time for us to follow our Lord. Let us receive the benediction. Go out into the world in peace. How kind. For all your work is good. Return no one evil for you. Strengthen the faith in heaven. Support the weak. Get the suffering. Honor and all the people. Love and serve the Lord, rejoicing in the power of the Christ. And the blessings of the Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be ever with you and remain with you always. Thank you. invite. This is Rina Thomas.
Everyone, please be a professional and a
are.
Now let us all stand for the decision. Achilles will go first. After that, Diamond will be a couple. And the environment and the group will go back. There will be my recommendation to be there.
The Lord be with you. Let us depart with the grace and peace.
Congratulations. God bless you.
Thank you.
Father, I said till death do us part, I want to mean it with all of my heart. Help me to love you more than I love her, than I know I can love her more than anyone else. And bring her in your presence today. Make her what you want her to be. I pray to hear her heart. I pray to love you more. I pray to cherish and serve her, and will bring you glory today.
Cherish and serve her, will bring you glory.